Hello dear students, I am going to explain you the chapter number 1 from Civics Political Science, class 9. Chapter number 1 is What is Democracy? Why Democracy? And I have divided this chapter topic wise. So this is the first topic where we are going to study about democracy. First question is, what is the meaning of democracy? What is democracy? So we go through the first definition, what is given here. Democracy is a form of government in which the rulers are elected by the people. Democracy is a form of government in which the rulers are elected by the people. What do we find here? Some keywords we find here. We find here government, we find here rulers, we find here elected or election. Now, first of all, we start from the meaning of the democracy. What is the literary meaning of the word democracy? This is a Greek word, democratia, from where this word has been originated. And the meaning, if we go into that, this word has been constituted by two words, demos and kratos or kratia. Demos referred to people and kratos referred to rule or power. It means rule of the people. So this is a Greek word and it emphasizes on the people, it emphasizes on the power. So the meaning is rule of the people, government of the people, power of the people. If we would go to the history from where this word has been originated or from where this type of government has been come or originated, then we have to go to the back history. What is the historical view? The historical view is what we find this word or type of government first used by Greeks in their city-state like Athens, when the people used to choose the government and the chosen or elected people or representative would rule. There is a very, very important definition of democracy, very, very famous definition of our democracy, which is given by Abraham Lincoln, and that is, democracy is the government of the people, by the people, for the people. It clarifies the meaning of democracy, that a type of government which comes from the people and it is for the benefit of the people and it is the government of the people, means people rule indirectly through their representatives. Now again, I come back to the previous definition, what we have found here. There are some components which comes out from there, that the components of democracy are the rulers, elections, the people and form of government. The rulers referred means who rules. Who rules? That is a question also. That who rules? It means that who are ruling, whether those who are elected by the people or the dictators or the monarch, what type of rulers we have. Second thing, second component is the election. Election means here people have right to choose. People have opportunity to choose the representative or the government. So this is a second component. And we have to also see here whether they have choice to choose or not. Third component is the people. People means who are going to vote. Who are going to vote or choose. Means that the people who are eligible citizen are able to cast their vote, whether it is fairly done or not. And the fourth component is what type of government we have. Because in some countries we find that dictators or monarchs, they rule, but in that countries, in those countries, elections are also conducted. But the main power we find that is in the hands of the monarchs. So what type of form of government is formed? Whether it is in the real sense, it is democratic, or it is just to show. So these are the main fundamental components of democracy. The rulers, who rules, elections, how the elections are conducted, people who are the voters who choose, and what type of government is formed, whether the government has power to take the decision or not independently, whether the people who are chosen, the representative who are chosen, they use the power or not. So these are the important component of democracy. Thank you.